Welcome back to another episode of Rock Boys Football. Lincoln Riley and the USC Trojans landing a commitment from a 2024 prospect who is relatively interesting, and you'll see the USC haters, which it just seems like all over social media, there are plenty of, will kind of knock this as an interesting take, but you see the national ranking according to 24/7 Sports, outside the top 1,000 national ranking, a three-star athlete, but when you kind of dig into what Lincoln Riley might be trying to do here, it starts to make a little bit more sense. And the first thing when you look at a guy like Hayden Treater is you love the frame. That is something you can't teach. 6'6", 300 pounds. He's played guard and tackle at the high school level, so you have some of that position versatility. But that's the biggest thing is the physicality and the frame and size that Hayden Treater is going to be bringing to the table. Now, before we get into the film and talk about what this USC class might be in 2024, again, I just want to say thank you to you guys, especially the USC fans who we've talked so much about the phenomenal job they've done in the transfer portal. And now Lincoln Riley seemingly kind of pivoting and taking a look at building this 2024 class out after a very good 2023 class. So appreciate you guys checking this out. Again, if you do enjoy the content, consider subscribing to the channel. We'll be getting into some of the official visitors they'll have on campus in the month of June. So for USC fans, it's going to be a busy next couple of weeks and months. So if you do enjoy it, lock in. You guys have been very, very supportive to the fellas. So we can't thank you guys enough for that. Let's get into Hayden Treater. And when I saw this commitment, I go watch a little bit of the film of him. I think you know exactly what Lincoln Riley's trying to do, and that's build some physicality on the line of scrimmage. You're moving to the Big Ten where you are dealing with I'm not necessarily saying the Big Ten's way better than the Pac-12, but it's a little bit of a different brand of football, and I think Lincoln Riley recognizes that and say, you're moving to the Big Ten. We want to have some physical dudes up front that can move some bodies. And one of the funniest storylines of this USC program last year in 2022 was they're a 7-on-17. They don't have any physicality on the line of scrimmage. Now, on the defensive line, outside of Thule, maybe there's an element of truth to that. That offensive line last year, Brett Nealon, Andrew Voorhees, and some of those other guys, that was a damn good group that was running the football at an extremely high level. And I think Lincoln Riley, as much as he gets credit for being that quarterback developer, quarterback whisperer, has had a good offensive lines, both at Oklahoma and that USC offensive line. Although might have struggled in pass protection a little bit, that was a physical group that could run the football. And you're seeing Lincoln Riley kind of go back to that well with a guy in Hayden Treater who maybe a little bit undervalued according to 24/7 Sports. But we had this conversation a lot, and we've talked about it on the recruiting trail a couple times. 24/7, On3, the ESPN Top 300, Rivals, those are all recruiting services that kind of stack the evaluations of these high school kids for the public. So you and I use them to kind of get a feel for who are the top kids coming out of high school. And this is in no way disrespecting what they do. They put a lot of time. I've listened to a lot of podcasts and a lot of the scouts of kind of how the sausage is made in terms of stacking these guys. And they do a good job. But there is an element of they don't get everybody. And some guys, like a guy like Hayden Treater, might be going under the radar. And you take a look at some of the offers that he had. I mean, Oregon came in with an offer. USC came in with an offer. I know Tennessee offered him as well. So there were some Power 5 teams that really like what Hayden Treater brings to the table. And yes, on 24/7, maybe a little undervalued, but Lincoln Riley in the scouting department at USC might have this guy as one of the better offensive tackles out in the West Coast. He's coming from the state of Colorado. So I think Lincoln Riley in the scouting department feel a lot better about this commitment than the public might think. And again, you're going to see Lincoln Riley, this USC program, you're going to have haters. And at times I could raise my hand and say, I've been one of them. I'm starting to trust the process a little bit in what Lincoln Riley is doing. So you'll see people kind of knock this as a three-star grab. Nothing to get too excited about. I think USC and the scouting department probably feel a little bit better about it than the public does. And what I want to get to a little bit is just really quickly take a look at what he brings to the table. He's a guy that you're going to see him playing that right guard position. So he's played on the inside. He's played tackle. He does have that tackle body, I will say, like that 6'6 frame, 300-plus pound guy. But what you're going to see that I think what Lincoln Riley kind of probably fell in love with and made the offer come out is how good he gets off the ball. You see a lot of tackles and offensive linemen come out of high school who are big. They just are big, and that's going to attract offers because programs say, hey, we can get this guy into a program and work around him. What I'm really excited and impressed about is how well he gets off the ball for a guy who's 6'6", 270 pounds, does play with some high pad level, which is something he'll get coached up with. And it, at a certain point, it's just hard when you're blocking guys who are 5'10 and you're 6'6. You're going to look high. But you look at here, pulling around, like, he's a really good athlete for someone who is 6'6, 300-plus pounds. And he is that Big Ten offensive lineman that you see. He's a road grader. He's a big bully in terms of the run game. And I think that's kind of why you see Lincoln Riley take a liking to a guy like Hayden Treader when maybe the public not so much into him. And you see he's just a road grader. I mean, working up double teams, going up to linebackers, like, there's a lot to like about him. And I will recognize in the state of Colorado, not necessarily the cream of the crop in terms of high school competition, but it's you see the physical traits on the screen here in terms of how good he's comfortable in space. He's a very, very physical offensive lineman. So, again, a lot to like, but what's even more you want to talk about a little bit is you check out the visitor list for the month of June. Now, this is the fourth commitment in the 2024 class. It's been maybe a little bit of a slow start for USC in this high school recruiting class in 2024, but you take a look at the caliber of players that are coming in visiting USC in the month of June, starting off with the June 16th official visit weekend. The number three wide receiver in the country, a top 10 national recruit, Mike Matthews, coming in. You had Taylor Tatum on campus this weekend, the number one running back in the country. A couple of guys that are really piquing my interest, Ryan Pelham. It seems like that's going to be a USC-Oregon battle for the four-star wide receiver out of Long Beach, California. DeAndre Carter from Mater Dei, I think you feel really good about in terms of building that physicality, and USC has done a really good job recruiting kids out of Mater Dei. Going down the list, Darian Mayo, a really intriguing defensive line, but you see kind of what I mean in the sense that they're having multiple top 100, top 50 dudes that will be on campus. And yes, on paper, in terms of commitment, it might be a slow start, but I really do think this USC recruiting class will be a top 10 class. And there's an element of talking about Lincoln Riley might be a little bit more aggressive in the transfer portal than other Power 5 teams. And it's hard to knock what he did with USC under year one. And it's another thing to talk about. It feels like Lincoln Riley's been at USC forever because of the success he had in year one. But this is his second year. He's going into his second year with this program. And I think as he gets the players he wants through the transfer portal, then he'll start turning his attention a little bit more to recruiting those high school classes a little bit stronger. The last guy I want to talk about before we kind of close it up is Elijah Brown. And so you get Malachi Nelson in the 2023 class. I think a lot of USC fans kind of see him as the quarterback of the future. You put kind of what it sounds like all your eggs in the Dylan Raiola basket, and you had some traction for a little bit. Now you're maybe pivoting and seeing what quarterback can we bring in this 2024 class. Elijah Brown from Mater Dei, it seems like the Stanford Cardinals are the team that's kind of leading in his recruitment. If USC wants to turn up the heat on a kid like Elijah Brown, I think it'd be very surprising if Lincoln Riley can't come in and win that recruitment battle. Now, one of the stories is, will Elijah Brown not want to follow a guy like Malachi Nelson in the 2023 class? And that would make a lot of sense. And I think there's two ways that USC could approach this. Is one, we'll go after Elijah Brown. You can't fight the fact that you're getting an elite arm in that 2024 class. But if Elijah Brown, maybe not extremely excited about following a guy like Malachi Nelson, who a lot of people think was the top quarterback in that 2023 class, I think you might just pivot to the 2025 class and look at recruiting the best arm in that 2025 class, a guy like Julian Lewis, who is a 2026 kid. I think that could be another route that USC could take. But at the end of the day, USC and Lincoln Riley has gotten a lot of heat for maybe addressing the transfer portal too much and not enough high school recruiting. The truth of the matter is Lincoln Riley took over this USC team and he wanted to win now. And the transfer portal offers you an opportunity to win now by getting proven guys who have played at the college football level. I think once Lincoln Riley gets to year two and year three and he gets his guys in the transfer portal, he feels happy about the current depth chart. Then I start to think that USC will kind of get it going on the recruiting trail and you'll start seeing top eight, top five classes pretty consistently. So USC fans, a slow start to the 2024 class. I think they're going to ramp it back up in the month of June once this transfer portal window kind of dies down. But a very interesting get here in Hayden Treader from the state of Colorado. Again, don't sleep on the 24/7 sports star ranking because this guy has a lot of traits to be a good offensive lineman for the USC Trojans and Lincoln Riley. Appreciate you guys supporting the channel. Again, the USC fans, just you guys have been absolutely awesome. So if you do enjoy the updates, consider subscribing to the channel. We appreciate you guys, and we'll talk to y'all later.